Instead of being separated as it is in the Western tradition. The cuffs, which were a symbol of the diaconate.
Again, oxen.
The stole?
Yes, that's.
This garment is similar to that sometimes worn by the deacons, it looks like. This is the belt. Belt.
Symbolic of a chaste life.
Yes, the cuffs. The cuffs were a symbol of the diaconate. They are
also used by the priest. It means that the hands are set apart for the use of God in sacramental functions, which is the hands are separated. They are now set aside to be used in. Now they clothe him with the sakkos, which is originally a garment worn by the emperors and has only been granted to bishops since roughly the latter part of the empire period, 14th, 15th century. Has bells on it, in remembrance, of course, of the high priest's garments in the Old Testament, which had bells on it.
Now the very special stole of the bishop is going to be presented. And it will fold over his shoulder, symbolizing his pastoral office as shepherd who carries the sheep.
It's called the omophorion, which means over the one that carries.
That was the shield.
Mm-hmm.
Which represents really the sword of the spirit.
Sword of the spirit.
When you couldn't carry a sword in the presence of the emperor, you were giving a shield. Much of the vestiture of the Eastern Church comes from the days of the Byzantine Empire.
Exactly.
It was given spiritual significance.
Well, the cross and the Panagia, meaning the All Holy One, or the engulpion, which it is called in Greek, meaning that it goes over the arm and rests on the chest. It is the emblem of the bishop, in addition to the cross, that with an image of our Blessed Mother or some saint very often, or our Lord. And finally, the crown, the mitre.
The Byzantine mitre.
All his fellow bishops, they greet each other with the words, Christ is in our midst, and they respond, He is and ever shall be.
Several bishops.
Various bishops, auxiliaries of Cleveland, Cincinnati, Columbus, Bishop of Youngstown, most of those of Ohio. Indianapolis.
This is Cardinal Cody, Cardinal Hickey from Washington, D.C. Great unity. unity between of the universal church.
Exactly.
The Catholic Church, East and West, united in its allegiance to the Holy Father as the point of unity for all Christians.
Holy One, Holy Mother God, let me render glory to you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always,
and forever and ever.
Now the choir sings thrice holy hymn, Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, which it is said was first learned by a young boy that fell asleep in a dream while in church in Constantinople. And the words of this were given to him as the hymn of heaven. It's used in the Latin Rite in the old reproaches of Good Friday.
As in Good Friday you hear this,
yes.
Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us. There is also the beautiful prayer of the Trisagion, which will be said by the bishop at the altar, God the Holy who abide in the saints, whom the seraphim praise with the thrice holy hymn, whom the cherubim glorify, whom all the heavenly powers worship, who brought all things into being out of nothingness, who created man in your own image and likeness, and adorned him with your favors. Give us wisdom and understanding. And then as it goes on, you hear the preparation for now the gifts.
It's at this point that the special blessing that the patriarch will invoke over the people.
Then the patriarch will bless with both hands and using the candles representing the Trinity and the Incarnation. Two natures, Christ, human and divine. Blessing with both hands, a unique privilege of Byzantine bishops.
That is sung by the patriarch is from the 80th psalm in the Old Testament as a blessing upon Israel. The church is the new Israel of God, and so its high priest invokes the blessing just as it was done many thousands of years ago upon the vineyard of our Lord, now in the Greek language.
Oh,
Byzantine chant traditionally is sung just by a single singer, as this one is doing, as the priest who is singing it, in a very elaborate way. It sounds rather oriental. It is perhaps closer to what the music of the synagogue and the early church really sounded like, rather than some of the more elaborate compositions we are used to hearing. Again, in the Arabic language, as of course most Melkite-Greek Catholics have, are of Arabic background and heritage, Christians
Lord,
in the Middle
look
East.
Down from heaven and see and bless this vineyard which your right hand has planted.
Faithful. And in Greek, ke apakosun, and hear us. Until recent years in Greece, even the king had his theme, and there was the polychronion, meaning the many years, God grant many years.
This is what the choir is singing now.
What the choir
grant, grant many years to holy and venerable patriarch, Maximus. God preserve him for many years.
Just intoned the theme itself, where he is called the patriarch of the great city of God of Antioch.